Workspace and whiteboard, it's never been easier to embrace hybrid work, even on mobile devices. I think I just broke my phone. Good thing we've got Vi Chow coming up next. He's a phone expert. And Vi, can I get a little help?
That was so cringe. Today, we're going to dive into Zoom, exploring what Zoom Mail, Zoom Calendar, Zoom Spots, and everything else launched at Zoomtopia 2022 was all about. We're going to give you everything you need to know about the new products in Zoom and what Zoom One is collectively and what they're trying to do to battle Microsoft and Google. So welcome, if you're new here, my name is Francesco. Welcome to Keep Productive. It's great to have you. So if you're interested in more of these tech roundups, news roundups, check out our news newsletter called The Routine if you fancy it. So they introduced Zoom Mail and Zoom Calendar. Really weird to see this housed in Zoom now, but it looks good. Mail looks pretty attractive. It looks like Apple Mail combined with a sort of more compact look. And the Zoom Calendar looks pretty decent in terms of housing everything in one location. Now that's the key. They're housing things in one location in something they're calling Zoom One. It's been out for a little bit of time. And what basically Zoom One is like Google Workspace, is like Microsoft as a 365 collective, trying to bring all of your experiences in one. Now, they haven't got documents, but they do have whiteboards and they do have meetings, phone, webinars, and phone. I think I mentioned that. But they're trying to house email and calendar underneath it now. And they're calling it toggle tax. I'd never heard of what toggle tax was, but toggle tax is basically the act of context switching between tools. So essentially what they're trying to do is reduce that because they found in a Harvard Business Review study that apparently employees lose 4 hours a week switching between tools in distracting themselves. So they want to bring that down and keep updated with Microsoft and even Slack and Google Workspace. So very simply, Zoom Mail, I want to say Zoho Mail, it's so similar. Zoom Mail is essentially a place where you can access third-party email accounts. So you can bring in, they haven't actually mentioned this, Gmail, Microsoft, all of the regular accounts that you're already using in your free and paid plans and use your email as you would. The only difference is if you're using a Zoom Mail services to Zoom Mail services, so you've got a buddy that's using Zoom Mail services, you can now send end-to-end encryption emails through that, which is pretty decent, a nice bonus of having both Zoom experiences. And of course, if you're a team, that makes more sense being able to collaborate there. So this will be housed in a desktop application along with Zoom Calendar. And the same goes to Zoom Calendar. If you're using Zoom Calendar services to Zoom Calendar services, you'll be able to easily book meetings with each other with little or no stress because they both work on the same system. So other things to note, if you've got Zoom Pro and Zoom Unlimited, you get 15 gigabytes of email storage. And if you're on the Zoom One business plan or higher, you'll get 100 gigabytes. So I don't actually know what the pricing is for the free in terms of how much storage you do actually get, but they haven't announced that. So I'll check into that as we roll through. I'll include the link to this full below. Zoom Mail and Zoom Calendar are essentially trying to catch up with Microsoft Teams in having everything housed in one location. Now, what else did they release to try and bring this together? Well, they also released something called Zoom Spots, which is like Slack Huddles with a bit of a twist. If you don't know what Slack Huddles are, it's essentially a place where you can start conversations fairly quickly. In Zoom Spots, you can join a spot and then start communicating with a certain department or team who are actively communicating, a bit like co-working. So you can co-work with each other, have conversations, and be able to start a chat on the right-hand side. It's trying to bring hybrid work in with maybe remote work and trying to weave that together. But more interestingly, what I quite liked about it is it's a sort of widget that lives on the right-hand side of your screen, allowing you to see people who you are interacting with. You can even go mute, or you can start conversations if you want to and use team chat, which is pretty decent ability. So they've really enhanced the team chat functions as well inside of this Zoomtopia event. They've really improved how you can communicate and it's all housed in one location, which means you can naturally share emails and relevant documents and files that are part of the team experience across your Zoom One account. They've also enhanced the way that meetings are now actually introduced something called smart recordings and templates, something that Microsoft introduced with their Microsoft Teams premium experience more recently. They also introduced better abilities with meeting avatars, and to be honest, they look god awful. I feel like this is such a trend in the team productivity space where avatars in video meetings need to be a thing. And I honestly, if someone can tell me in the comments below why we need to have these meta avatars, I without glasses, it seems so weird. I don't want to be a cat in a meeting. Maybe for 5 minutes or like just to have a laugh out of everyone, but I don't want to be a cat in a meeting, or I don't want my own digital avatar. I don't know the benefit. Please help me if you know the benefit in the description below. So all in all, Zoom One has become more of a Google Workspace experience. It's housing a lot more phone, meetings, team chat, whiteboards, webinars, and now mail and calendar. And if you look at this as a collective experience, Zoom One is trying to be like Google Workspace and the likes of Microsoft 365, trying to house everything in one location. The one thing it seems to lack, although having the whiteboard abilities, is the ability to connect documents up, or at least have a canvas-like experience that Slack have introduced more recently. They are rolling this out, and currently the mail version is in beta, and Zoom Spots will come out in early 2023. So I'd love to dive into this, explore this, and really get an idea of how it works and operates in practicality. So folks, I really hope you enjoyed today's video. If it was helpful, please do give it a thumbs up. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more, subscribe, it'd be great to have you. And if you fancy checking out more videos, we'll have them in the end screen where you'll see more about Keep Productive. Oh my God, I just want to watch this cringe moment again. It was so awkward as part of an event. It's possibly the worst segue I've ever seen in a TED talk. It's like me looking at the grass now going, I need to cut that grass, haha. Here are my plants. I don't know, it's so cringe. I've never seen anything like it. I'll let you be the judge of that and enjoy this cringy clip. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll look forward to seeing you all very soon. Cheerio.
Workspace and whiteboard, it's never been easier to embrace hybrid work, even on mobile devices. I think I just broke my phone. Good thing we've got Vi Chow coming up next. He's a phone expert. And Vi, can I get a little help?